Subscribe the Pharmacology Concerts by Rajesh Chaudhary and press the bell icon for the upcoming videos. Thank you. Hello friends, welcome to my channel Pharmacology Concerts by Rajesh Chaudhary, and in this video I will discuss some important and basic MCQs of sympathetic nervous system. And this question basically focus for the GPAT and NAPAR, and you can pause the video to read the question properly and try to solve this question, then I will tell the answer. So let's start the MCQs. So take a look of question number 1, then I will tell the answer. So right answer is the C, Mipramine. So basically all of these drugs are the neurotransmission modulator, जो ये कहीं ना कहीं आपके सिम्पेथेटिक सिस्टम की एक्टिविटी को चेंज करते हैं या फिर इन्हेंस करते हैं या फिर इनहिबिट करते हैं. फॉर एग्जांपल द अल्फा मिथाइल टायरोसिन एंड मिथाइल डोपा बेसिकली आर द मेटाबॉलिक इनहिबिटर एंड दे इंटरफेयर विद द सिंथेसिस ऑफ कैटेकोलामिन्स, देयरफॉर दे डिक्रीज द एक्टिविटी ऑफ सिम्पेथेटिक नर्वस सिस्टम. व्हाइल द इंफ्रामिन इनहिबिट्स द न्यूरल अपटेक एंड इनहेंस द लेवल ऑफ कैटेकोलामिन्स एट द सिनेप्टिक जंक्शंस एंड लीड टू द एक्टिवेशन ऑफ सिम्पेथेटिक सिस्टम, देयरफॉर दे इट इनहेंसेस द activity of sympathetic nervous system. But reserpine inhibits the vesicle transport and lead to the metabolism of catecholamines at the neurons, therefore it may decrease the activity of sympathetic nervous system. तो इसलिए आपका जो इंप्रामिन है वो stimulate करता है, बाकी जो और ड्रग हैं वो inhibit करता है आपके sympathetic neurotransmission को. So C is the right answer for this question. And now take a look of question number 2. So for this question answer is the D, all of the above, means the release of norepinephrine, activation of adrenal receptors like alpha and beta, and release of epinephrine from adrenal medulla can stimulate the sympathetic system. Therefore answer is the D, all of the above. Now come to the next question, question number 3. Take a look. So answer is the B, alpha 2 receptors, because they acts by the GIPCR, means they inhibit the cyclic AMP production by the inhibition of adrenal cyclase enzyme. Therefore answer is the B. And baat kare hum other receptors ki, to alpha 1 basically kaam karta hai GQPCR ke through, and the activation of GQPCR may enhance the level of IP3 and DAG, and the beta receptors basically work by the GSPCR, means they enhance the level of cyclic AMP. Therefore answer is the B, alpha 2 receptors, which decrease the intracellular level of cyclic AMP. Now come to the question number 4. Take a look. So for this question answer is the C, papillary dilator muscles. Question mein pucha gaya hai ki inme se kaun se tissues mein beta receptor nahi hote. So basically we know that the alpha bronchial muscles contains beta 2 receptors, heart mainly contain beta 1 receptors, and the fat cell mainly contains beta 3 receptors, and only alpha 1 receptor contained by the papillary dilator muscles. इसलिए आंसर है आपका C. जैसे कि हम इमेज में देख सकते हैं कि आपका जो alpha 1 receptors है वो basically dilator muscles में पाए जाते हैं, जबकि आपका circular muscles पे M3 और beta 2 दोनों होते हैं. इसलिए papillary dilator muscles only contain alpha 1 receptors. Therefore answer is the C, papillary dilator muscles. Now come to the next question, question number 5. Take a look. So for this question answer is the B, intestine. Means आपके alpha 1 और alpha और beta दोनों का जो effect है वो same होगा आपके intestine पे. Means both receptor cause the relaxation of intestine muscles. बात करें हम अलग अलग tissue पे, तो blood vessels पे alpha 1 basically contact करता है और beta 2 रिलैक्स करता है. एंड बात करें इंटेस्टाइन की, तो अल्फा और बीटा दोनों रिलैक्सेंट इफेक्ट शो करते हैं. बात करें यूटरस की या फिर ब्रोंकियल मसल्स की, तो दोनों में अल्फा 1 कॉन्ट्रैक्टर की तरह काम करता है और बीटा 2 रिलैक्सेंट की तरह काम करता है. देयरफॉर आंसर इज द बी, इंटेस्टाइन. नाउ कम टू द क्वेश्चन नंबर 6. सो for this question answer is the D, all of the above. Means heart, peripheral resistance और venous return को affect करके sympathomimetic drug blood pressure को regulate कर सकता है. जैसा कि we know that the heart contains mainly beta receptors, they regulate the heart rate, and therefore it may regulate the blood pressure by the heart rate. And the peripheral stents mainly regulated by the alpha 1 and beta 2, and the venous stent mainly regulated by the beta 1 receptors by the renin release. Therefore all these parameters affect the blood pressure. Now come to the question number 7. Take a look. So for this question, answer is the B, increase in the peripheral arterial resistance. As we know that the beta non-selective beta receptors agonist means isoprenaline, and isoprenaline mainly worked in the beta 1 and beta 2 receptors, and activation of beta 1 receptors may cause the increase in heart rate, force of contraction and cardiac output, and the activation of beta 2 receptors mainly cause the decrease in the total peripheral resistance and mean pressure. Therefore answer is the B, because isoprenaline doesn't cause the increase in peripheral artery resistance. Now take a look of question number 8. So for this question, answer is the C, methoxamine. So basically methoxamine is a alpha 1 receptor agonist, and all baki jo hain aapke dobutamine, isoprenaline ya phir epinephrine, wo aapke ek tarike se beta receptor ko activate kar sakte hain. Now come to the question number 9. So simple, answer is the D, all of the above. Means in tino tarike se aapka blood glucose level badh sakta hai, means hyperglycemia effect mil sakta hai by the gluconeogenesis, that is caused by the beta 2 activation, and inhibition of insulin secretion by the alpha 2 receptors, and the stimulation of glycogenolysis by the beta 2 receptors. So now take a look at question number 10. So for this question, answer is the C, phenylephrine, because phenylephrine is the selective alpha 1 receptor agonist, and which can effectively use in the diuretic and nasal decongestant. So therefore answer is the C, phenylephrine. Now come to the question number 11. Take a look. So for this question, answer is the B, norepinephrine, because norepinephrine is the alpha 1 receptor agonist, and which can use in the chronic orthostatic hypotension. Baki jo aapka ephedrine hai ya epinephrine hai ya salmeterol hai, wo hum use nahi karte. Now come to the question number 12. So for this question, answer is the B, dobutamine. And we can also use the epinephrine for the cardiogenic shock. So basically aapka jo alpha dobutamine hai wo beta 1 receptor agonist hai, jo ki aapke cardiac function ko enhance karta hai, isliye hum iska use cardiogenic shock mein karte hain. Jabki norepinephrine ya methoxamine jo hai wo ek tarike se alpha 1 receptor agonist hai, iska hum use nahi karte hain, ya uska use jo hai hum ek tarike se hypovolemic ya fir hypotensive mein use karte hain. Aur isoprenaline jo hai ya isoprenaline jo hai ek tarike se non selective hai, isliye hum iska use bhi nahi karte hain, isliye dobutamine is the preferred answer. Now come to the question number 13. Take a look. Similar, answer is the C, epinephrine, and we can also use the dobutamine because they are the beta 1 receptor agonist. Baat kare methoxamine ya zalmeterjoline ki, to wo aapke beta 1 pe kaam nahi karte hain, isliye hum basically epinephrine hi use karte hain aapke cardiac arrest ke case mein. Now come to the question number 14. Take a look. So for this, answer is the D, phenoxybenzamine, because these are the irreversible alpha receptor antagonist. Baki jo hain tulazolin ho ya fir aapka leptalol ho ya prazosin ho, wo reversible antagonist hai, lekin aapka phenoxybenzamine aapka irreversible alpha receptor antagonist hai, kyunki ye aapka covalently bound karta hai aapke alpha receptor pe. Isliye this is the answer for this question. Now come to the question number 15. Take a look. So for this question, answer is the C, pheochromocytoma. Basically, non-selective alpha 1 receptor agonist like phenoxybenzene and phentolamine are used in the pheochromocytoma, and not for the others. Now, come to the question number 16. So for this question, answer is the D, prazosin, and prazosin effectively used in the treatment of moderate to mild to moderate hypertension. Now come to the question number 17. Take a look. So for this question, answer is the B, metoprolol. Question में ये है कि अगर आपको एंटी हाइपरटेंसिव ड्रग यूज़ करना हो और उस पेशेंट को अस्थमा, डायबिटीज और पेरिफेरल वेस्कुलर डिसीज है तो उस केस में कौन सा ड्रग प्रिफर्ड होगा, तो आंसर इज द मेटोप्रोलोल, क्योंकि प्रोप्रेनोल का यूज़ हम अस्थमा पे नहीं करते हैं. टिमेडोल का बेसिक यूज़ जो है आपके ग्लूकोमा में यूज़ करते हैं एज ए टॉपिकल सोल्यूशन, और नोडोलॉल का यूज़ खास उतना नहीं है, इसलिए हम मेटोप्रोलोल इज द प्रिफर्ड आंसर फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन. नाउ टेक ए लुक अप क्वेश्चन नंबर 18. So, right answer is the cerebral hemorrhage, C. So, C is the right answer for this question, क्योंकि ये आपका बहुत ही serious problem होता है आपके epinephrine के case में. Now, come to the question number 19. So, for this question, answer is the A, P and Q are the right statement, means आपका जो रिट्रोडीन है इसे बीटा टू एगोनिस्ट, और इसका यूज़ हम इसे यूट्राइन रिलैक्सेंट के रूप में यूज़ करते हैं, एंड इट आल्सो प्रोड्यूस अरिथमिया एज साइड इफेक्ट. सो देयरफॉर आंसर इज द ए, पी एंड क्यू स्टेटमेंट आर द राइट. नाउ कम टू द क्वेश्चन नंबर 20. टेक ए लुक. सो फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन आंसर इज द ए, नॉर एड्रेनालिन, क्योंकि आपका जो नॉरएड्रेनालिन है इट मे कॉज द रिफ्लेक्स ब्रेडिकार्डिया बिकॉज इट इन्हेंस द हाइपरटेंशन, क्योंकि आपका जो ब्लड प्रेशर को इंक्रीज करता है इसलिए आपका इसमें रिफ्लेक्स ब्रेडिकार्डिया होता है उसको कंपनसेट करने के लिए. बाकी जो ड्रग हैं फिनोक्सीबेंजामिन हो या फिर आपका एसोप्रिनोलिन हो या प्राजोसिन हो, यह एक तरीके से बीपी को कम करते हैं, और इनके केस में आपका रिफ्लेक्स ब्रेडिकार्डिया होता है, इसलिए आपका जो आंसर है आपका क्या होगा, ए, नॉरएड्रेनालिन, बिकॉज इट प्रोड्यूसेस रिफ्लेक्स ब्रेडिकार्डिया. So these are the basic questions of sympathetic nervous system. If you like my videos, please subscribe my YouTube channel for the upcoming videos, and in last, thank you for watching.